Hello friends, and welcome back to another PowerPoint animation tutorial in which we are going to make an animated background, which is inspired by Al Broadman's work at dribbble.com. You can check his other work as the link to his page is given in the video description. We used only spin animation to replicate the same effect in Microsoft PowerPoint. Let's get started by opening the selection pane from the Home tab, and there you can see a huge list of shape objects that we draw and used in this presentation. Along with the selection pane, if we also investigate the animation pane, then you can see a long list of the spin effects that we applied to all these shapes. But don't you worry, as we only need to animate two of these vertical and horizontal half spherical shapes, and later, we will duplicate both to fill up the presentation. To create these shapes, you can use two different methods. The first is to take an oval shape and then draw a rectangle on top while covering half of the oval. Then from the Shape Format tab, use the Merge Shapes, Subtract command. You can watch our tutorial on how to enable Merge Shapes if you are using PowerPoint 2010. Merge Shapes is not available in earlier versions of PowerPoint than 2010. So, you can use the second method by drawing a partial circle and then using the yellow handler to make it half. You then need to draw more oval shapes on top of the partial circle, as you can see in our presentation. Through the selection pane, you can notice that the partial circle has been placed separately and both the full grouped ovals have been placed on top of it. If we now talk about the animation effects, then you can see that we applied the spin effect only to the grouped oval shapes but not to the partial circle, and all the partial circles are static. Once you have these three oval shapes in place, select the grouped ovals and then apply the spin effect from the emphasis section of the animations drop-down menu. Here you can see that we are using 180 degree counterclockwise rotation with 0.3 seconds start and end smoothness, and applied the auto reverse. The time duration of the effect is 0.6 seconds, and repeating this effect until the end of the slide. The next step is to copy and paste these three ovals and place them at the bottom. From the Shapes Format tab, click the Rotate drop-down menu and choose Flip Vertical. Adjust the positions, and then from the Animation tab, double-click on the second spin effect and change the rotate from counterclockwise to clockwise, and add a delay timings of 0.05 seconds to this effect. Now select all the six ovals, that is both the grouped shapes with hidden ovals, and replicate at the bottom. You can either use the copy and paste command, or you can also drag and drop at the bottom while holding the control key. You can then use the F4 key, or Control plus Y to repeat the last command to make more duplicates at the bottom. The only thing you need to do now is to adjust the delay timings of each of the effects and add a 0.05 second delay to each of the spin effects. See the slideshow, and there you have one row of spinning ovals ready. Make further copies of all these grouped oval shapes to the right. Selecting all these ovals and dragging and dropping them while holding the control key is the easier method of making duplicates. Now, flip all the second row ovals horizontally and then start changing their spin effect rotation from clockwise to anti-clockwise and vice versa. Finally, select all the shapes and make further copies, and there you have a nice distraction animated background ready to use. I hope you will find this video informative, and you might have learned something new. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting. Subscribe to our channel as there are a lot more videos to come. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.